وأقول في القرآن ما جاءت به آياته فهو الكريم المنزال وأقول قال الله جل جلاله والمصطفى الهادي ولا أتأول
الحمد لله رب العالمين له الحمد الحسن والثناء الجميل وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له يقول الحق وهو يهدي السبيل وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه والتابعين لهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين أما بعد إن شاء الله تعالى today I'm going to be going through these verses بإذن الله الكريم قال تبارك وتعالى إن الذين كذبوا بآياتنا واستكبروا عنها لا تفتح لهم أبواب السماء لا تفتح لهم أبواب السماء ولا يدخلون الجنة حتى يلج الجمل في سم الخياط وكذلك نجزي المحسنين وكذلك نجزي المجرمين لهم من جهنم مهاد ومن فوقهم غواش وكذلك نجزي الظالمين الله سبحانه وتعالى he says إن الذين the ones كذبوا بآياتنا who disbelieved in our verses. What is it they disbelieved in? The verses, the signs, جاءت بها رسول الله, the messengers of Allah came with, they disbelieved in it. وأعرضوا عن التصديق بأخبارها, believing in the news that they came with, they rejected it. And they also rejected and they turned away from what? والعمل بأحكامها, and acting upon the rulings and the jurisprudent rulings and the theological rulings that these prophets came with, they rejected it. What did the prophets come with, brothers and sisters? They came with two things, al-akhbar and al-ahkam. They came with akhbar, news, things that have happened in the past, they talked about, things that are going to happen in the future, jannah and this and etc. They disbelieved in all of that. إِنَّ الَّذِينَ كَذَّبُوا بِآيَاتِنَا They disbelieved in the akhbar and the news. Also, what did they turn away from and they rejected? They rejected وَالْعَمَلِ بِأَحْكَامِهَا Acting upon those ahkam. And the ahkam are two types. Ahkam which are ilmiyah and ahkam which are amaliyah. Ahkam which are ilmiyah are aqaid related issues. Believing in Allah tabarak wa ta'ala's oneness, not associating partners with Him subhanahu wa ta'ala, and that He's the only one who deserves to be worshipped. This is a what? It's a hukum. It's a hukum shar'i, which is like in ilmi. And there's a second type, which is hukum shar'i, which is amali, which is the previous nations were also, they prayed, they fasted, and etc. They turned away from all of that as well. They rejected it. They didn't believe in it. Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, He said, إِنَّ الَّذِينَ the ones, يعني كذبوا بآياتنا means what? أي كذبوا بآياتي التي جاءت بها رسلي. Allah is saying, the ones who have disbelieved in my ayat, that my messengers came with, وَأَعْرَضُوا عَنْهَا, and they turned away from it. وَاسْتَكْبَرُوا عَنْهَا, it means a وَأَعْرَضُوا عَنْهَا. They were arrogant and turned away from it. They turned away from two things. التصديق بأخبارها, number one. Believing in the news those prophets came with. والعمل بأحكامها, and acting upon those ahkam that those prophets came with. Allah تبارك وتعالى tells us what? لا تفتح لهم أبواب السماء. What does that mean? أي لا يسعد لهم في حياتهم إلى الله قول ولا عمل. Those people to Allah تبارك وتعالى will not ascend. To Allah تبارك وتعالى it will not ascend. Any good speech that they come with, any good actions that they do will not ascend to Allah تبارك وتعالى. It won't go up. ولا يجاب لهم دعاء, and none of their supplication will be accepted. ولا تنزل إليهم بركات, and the blessings of Allah will not descend on them. ورحمات, the mercy of Allah will not descend on them. And also, ولا تفتح لهم أبواب السماء also means لا تفتح لأرواحهم إذا ماتوا أبواب السماء. When they die and they pass away and they leave this world, their soul will not go up to Allah تبارك وتعالى. It will be rejected. ولذلك العلامة محمد الأمين الشنقيطي, he mentions in the tafsir, he says في عدم فتح أبواب السماء لهم أقوال متقاربة معروفة لا يكذب بعضها بعضا وهي كلها حق. قال بعض العلماء لا تفتح لهم أبواب السماء فيرفع لهم منها عمل صالح لأن أعمالهم مردودة إلى الله كما قال تعالى إليه يصعد الكلم الطيب والعمل الصالح يرفعه والكفار ليس عندهم عمل صالح يرفع كلمهم وليس عندهم كلم طيب. وقال بعض العلماء لا تفتح لهم أبواب السماء لاستجابة دعواتهم لأن دعواتهم مردودة وما دعاء الكافرين إلا في ضلال. وقال بعض العلماء لا تفتح لهم أبواب السماء أي لا تنزل إليهم البركات والرحمات من الله لكفرهم وكل هذه الأقوال حق. وذهب جماهير من المفسرين أن معنى لا تفتح لهم لأرواحهم عند الموت والآية تشتمل أما والآية تشمل هذا كله. And that's why I mentioned what I just said about the tafsir of the ayah, that those people who disbelieved in the ayat that the messengers came with, and they turned away from what? وَأَعْرَضُوا عَنِ التَّصْدِيقِ بِأَخْبَارِهَا, and they turned away from believing in the news and the information that those prophets came with. وَالْعَمَلِ بِأَحْكَامِهَا, and they turned away and refused to act upon the rulings, the judgments that those messengers have passed. They refused to act upon it. I mentioned all the views for them. لا تفتح لهم أبواب السماء. I mentioned لا يسعد لهم في حياتهم إلى الله قول ولا عمل. None of their actions and their speeches will go up to Allah تبارك وتعالى. No. Because who are they? They're disbelievers. They're criminals. Why would it go to Allah? What goes to Allah is that which is good. إليه يصعد الكلم الطيب والعمل الصالح يرفع. The actions which are risen to Allah تبارك وتعالى are actions which are what? والعمل الصالح. Good actions, and the actions which are good are the actions that fulfill two conditions. Al-ikhlas wal-mutaba'a is done with sincerity and it is done in accordance to the sunnah. The non-Muslims don't have that, so none of their actions and their speeches is ever going to be risen to Allah tabarak wa ta'ala. They can give money to the poor, they can open charities, they can open hospitals, they can care, doesn't matter. لا يسعد لهم في حياتهم إلى الله قول ولا عمل. Also, وَلَا يُجَابُ لَهُمْ دُعَاءٌ, none of their du'as will be accepted. As Allah said, وَمَا دُعَاءُ الْكَافِرِينَ إِلَّا فِي الضَّلَالِ. All of the du'a that they make, is all of it is going to go to misguidance. It's going to go away. It's not going to benefit them. Also, what is it? وَلَا تُنَزَّلُ إِلَيْهِمْ بَرَكَاتٌ وَرَحَمَاتٌ, Allah's mercy will not descend on them, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah's mercy, Allah's blessings will not come down onto them. وَلَا تُفَتَّحُ لِأَرْوَاحِهِمْ إِذَا مَاتُوا أَبْوَابُ السَّمَاءِ, and when they die, their soul will not be taken up to Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, and the doors of the heavens will not be open for them. We all know the famous hadith, Al-Imam Ahmad narrated in his Musnad, min hadith al-Bara ibn Azib radiyallahu ta'ala anhu. This hadith is what? Al-Bara ibn Azib said, kharajna ma'an nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam fi janazati rajul min al-ansar. One day we went with the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to the janazah of a man from the people of Ansar. فانتهينا إلى القبر, we came to the grave, ولما يلحد فجلس رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم, they came to the janaza, this is the body, and اللحد means when you place a person in the grave, there's a side that you put the person in, okay, that's لحد, that's what the meaning of the word اللحد means, يدفن في اللحد, مرقاة المفاتيح, that's how مبارك فوري mentions it. So ولما يلحد فجلس على رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم, the Prophet sat down عليه الصلاة والسلام, وجلسنا حوله, the Sahaba, they sat around him صلوات الله وسلامه عليه, and when they sat around him كأن على رؤوسنا الطير, it was like birds were on our heads, وفي يده عود ينكت في الأرض, the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, he had a twig, and he was scribbling and he was writing on the earth. فَرَفْعَ رَأْسَهُ He raised his head up, صَلَوَاتُ اللَّهِ وَسَلَامُهُ عَلَيْهِ فَقَالَ He said to the Sahabas, استعيذوا بالله من عذاب القبر استعيذوا بالله من عذاب القبر استعيذوا بالله من عذاب القبر مرتين أو ثلاثا twice or three times he said seek refuge in Allah from the punishment of the grave seek refuge in Allah from the punishment of the grave seek refuge in Allah from the punishment of the grave ثم قال then the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم he said now he goes into a journey that every one of us is going to go through a journey that we cannot run away from A journey that's going to start for every single one of us at one point. At one point, this journey is going to start for us. Then the Prophet started to mention the journey. What did he say? Inna al-abda al-mu'mina. May Allah make us from him. May Allah make us from the mu'mineen. The believer, the mu'min, إِذَا كَانَ فِي انْقِطَاعٍ مِنَ الدُّنْيَا When he leaves this earth. وَإِقْبَالٍ مِنَ الْآخِرَةِ He leaves this earth. He disconnects from the earth. And now he's towards the hereafter. نزل إليه ملائكة من السماء بيض الوجوه Angels will come down from the sky. Their faces are white. كأن وجوههم الشمس is like their faces is the sun. معهم كفن من أكفان الجنة They have with them a shroud from the shrouds of Jannah. وحنوط من حنوط الجنة And with them they have حنوط. What does a حنوط mean? It means ما يخلط من الطيب لأكفان الموتى وأجسادهم مرقاة المفاتيح That's what is mentioned Which مرقاة المفاتيح That's what he mentions It means يعني it's like a oud It's like a misk ها It's what you mix with the shroud when the person dies حتى So they come The angels come with that shroud And it smells nice حتى يجلس منه مد البصر The person is on his deathbed He's dying right He's leaving the dunya. The nafs is leaving his body. He's going towards the akhirah. So they sit in that position. So at the head. With the cloth, waiting. يَجِئُ مَلَكُ الْمَوْتِ The angel of death now comes. حَتَّى يَجْلِسَ عِنْدَ رَأْسِهِ He will sit next to his head. فَيَقُولُ He will say, يَا أَيَّتُهَا النَّفْسُ الطَّيِّبَةِ Oh, blessed soul. أُخْرُجِ إِلَى مَغْفِرَةٍ مِّنَ اللَّهِ وَرِضْوَانِ Come out. Come out to what? To the forgiveness of your Lord. Come out to what? The pleasure of your Lord. فَتَخْرُجُ تَسِيلُ كَمَا تَسِيلُ الْقَطْرَةُ مَنْ فِي السِّقَاءِ مَنْ فِي السِّقَاءِ It will come out with simplicity and ease. It won't go hard. فَيَأْخُذُهَا He will take it. What do you call it? A kettle, water just dripping from it. So simple, so easy. No simple hard. أَيَّتُهَا النَّفْسُ الطَّيِّبَةِ That's what it's being called. أَيَّتُهَا النَّفْسُ الطَّيِّبَةِ Come forward. أُخْرُجِي إِلَى مَغْفِرَةٍ مِّنَ اللَّهِ Come to the forgiveness of your Lord. Come to what? إِلَى رِضْوَانٍ Come to the pleasure of your Lord. فَتَخْرُجُ It will come out. تَسِيلُ كَمَا تَسِيلُ الْقَطْرَةُ مِّنْ فِي السِّقَاءِ فَيَأْخُذُهَا He will grab it. The nafs will come quickly at it. The angel of death will grab it like that. فَإِذَا أَخَذَهَا When the angel of death grabs it, لَمْ يَدَعْهَا فِي يَدِهِ طَرْفَةَ عَيْنٍ He won't keep it in his hand for a split second. حتى يأخذوها The angels who had the shroud, that shroud that smelled nice, the angels that came down, whose faces were white like the sun, they will take over it. فَيَجْعَلُوا فِي ذَلِكَ الْكَفَنِ They will place it in the shroud. وَفِي ذَلِكَ الْحَنُوطِ وَيَخْرُجُ مِنْهَا What would come out from that soul, the smell that's going to come from it, what is it, brothers? كَأَطْيَبِ نَفْحَةِ مِسْكٍ وُجِدَتْ عَلَى وَجْهِ الْأَرْضِ It will be the best fragrance. On the face of this earth, better than any fragrance you've ever seen, better than anything you've ever smelled, the best smell ever. That's what's going to be. فَيَسْعَدُونَ بِهَا They will take that soul with the shroud in it, and they'll go up into the sky. فَلَا يَمُرُّونَ بِهَا عَلَى مَلَئٍ مِّنَ الْمَلَائِكَةِ They don't go by a group of the angels. إِلَّا قَالُوا Except the angels will say, مَا هَذَا الرُّوحُ الطَّيِّبُ What is this blessed soul? فَيَقُولُونَ The angels will respond, فلان ابن فلان This is so and so بأحسن أسمائه التي كانوا يسمونه They will refer to him by the best name that he used to have في الدنيا in this earth حتى ينتهوا بها إلى السماء الدنيا Until they come to the سماء الدنيا فيستفتحون له The angels will request Okay, open the gates for him Open the sky, سماء for him فيفتح له It will be open for him Look at that فَيُشَيِّعُهُ مِنْ كُلِّ سَمَاءٍ مُقَرِّبُهَا إِلَى السَّمَاءِ الَّتِي تَلِيهَا. Every single sama, there's going to be angels that are going to يعني escort this person to the next. And the angels are all going to follow that soul. They love it. It's an honorable person. فَيُشَيِّعُهُ, he'll be escorted by what? مِنْ كُلِّ سَمَاءٍ, from every heaven, مُقَرِّبُهَا, the closest. إِلَى السَّمَاءِ الَّتِي تَلِيهَا. They will pass it on and pass it on. He's got entourage, honorable person. حَتَّى يُنْتَهَى بِهَا إِلَى السَّمَاءِ السَّابِعَةِ, until he comes to the seven heaven. فَيَقُولُ اللَّهُ عَزِّ وَجَلَّ, Allah will say, أُكْتُبُ كِتَابَ عَبْدِي فِي عِلِّيِّينَ, write my slave in the book, عِلِّيِّينَ, write him in that book. That's the book he's going to be written. عِلِّيِّينَ is a diwanu al-muqarrabina. Diwanu al-muqarrabina. Sahibu Mirqati al-Mufatih, that's what he mentions in Mubarak Furi. What is it? What? عِلِّيِّينَ هُوَ دِيوَانُ الْمُقَرَّبِينَ. It is it's the book and the record book for those people who are close to Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala. جَعَلَنِ اللَّهُ وَإِيَّاكُمْ, may Allah make us from those people. وَأَعِيدُوهُ إِلَى الْأَرْضِ, and Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala will say, write his name in the book, عِلِّيُّون, honorable person he is. وَأَعِيدُوهُ إِلَى الْأَرْضِ, and take his body back to the earth. يعني take his soul, sorry, back to the earth. His bodies of the dunya, like he take his soul back to the earth. فإني منها خلقتهم, Allah تبارك وتعالى says, from it I created him. ومن, the dunya, the earth, take him back to the earth, because I created him from the earth in the first place, so take him back to the earth. وفيها أعيدهم, and from it I will bring him out. ومنها أخرجهم تارة أخرى, he was created from it, and the earth he will return back to, and he will come out from there as well. فتعاد روحه في جسده, the soul will come back and it will be placed in his body. فيأتيه ملكان, by that time he's made it to the grave, two angels will come. فيجلسانه, those two angels will be sat. فيقولان له, they will say to him, من ربك, who's your Lord? فيقول, the person will respond, ربي الله, my Lord is Allah. He's worshipped Allah all his life. He lived by being a slave to Allah. He says, ربي الله, my Lord is Allah. فيقولان له, they say to him, ما دينك, what's your religion? فيقول, he says, ديني الإسلام, my religion is الإسلام. فيقولان له, then they say to him, ما هذا الرجل الذي بعث فيكم, what is this man that was sent out from amongst you? فيقول, he will say, هو رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم, he is the messenger of Allah صلى الله عليه وسلم. فيقولان له, then they say to him, وما علمك, what knowledge do you have of him? فيقول, he will say, قرأت كتاب الله, I read the book of Allah. فآمنت به, I believed in it. وصدقت, فينادي مناد في السماء, a caller will call from the sky, and صدق عبدي, my slave has told the truth. فأفرشوه من الجنة وألبسوه من الجنة وافتحوا له بابا إلى الجنة, this is my slave, فأفرشوه من الجنة, يعني make a firash for him, a place to sleep, a place to lie down, a place to relax in Jannah. وألبسوه من الجنة, his grave will be turned in a place where he can lie down and relax. It's like a firash for him. وَأَلْبِسُوهُ مِنَ الْجَنَّةِ, and guess what? Clothe him from Jannah. وَافْتَحُ لَهُ بَابًا إِلَى الْجَنَّةِ, open a door for him to Jannah. Let that fragrance of Jannah come to him, that breeze of Jannah come to him. فَيَأْتِيهِ مِنْ رَوْحِهَا, the wind of Jannah will come to him. وَطِيبِهَا, the blessings and the smell of it. وَيُفْسَحُ لَهُ فِي قَبْرِهِ مَدَّ بَصَرِهِ, and the grave will be widened for him. وَيَأْتِيهِ رَجُلٌ حَسَنُ الْوَجْهِ, a man who's so beautiful will come to him. حَسَنُ الْثِيَابِ, this man looks extremely handsome. He's wearing beautiful clothing. طَيِّبُ الْرِيحِ, the smell that's coming from this individual is so nice. So this person is in his grave and he sees this person. He sees an individual in front of him. A man who's so beautiful, handsome. He's wearing beautiful clothes. He smells extremely nice. فَيَقُولُ, the person who's in his grave says, أَبْشِرْ بِالَّذِي يَسُرُّكُ, هذا يوم الذي كنت توعد. The person who's the handsome man, the man who smelled nice, the man who looks يعني attractive, will say to this man, he will say to him, glad tidings in that which is going to bring you happiness. هذا يومك الذي كنت توعد, this was the day that you were promised. فيقول, he will then say, من أنت, who are you? Who are you? He doesn't know him. And then فَوَجْهُ كَالْوَجْهُ يَجِئُ بِالْخَيْرِ. You look like a face, an individual is coming with something good. Who are you? And this is what he says. فَيَقُولُ أَنَا عَمَلُكَ الصَّالِحِ. I am your righteous deeds. فَيَقُولُ Then he says, رَبِّي my Lord, أَقِمِ السَّاعَةِ. أَقِمِ السَّاعَةِ, my Lord, I want the hour to strike now. حَتَّى أَرْجِعَ إِلَى أَهْلِ وَمَالِي. I want to go back to my children. I want to go back to my wife. I want to go back to my wealth. Oh Allah, tabarak wa ta'ala, I want the hour to happen. It's a person who worked hard. What is it, brothers and sisters? Underline that part of the hadith. This is where you need to ponder. What was it that it said? أَنَا عَمَلُكَ الصَّالِحِ. I am your righteous deeds. That's the believer. That was the story of the believer. What about the kafir? وَإِنَّ الْعَبْدَ الْكَافِرَ, the disbeliever, إِذَا كَانَ فِي انْقِطَاعٍ مِنَ الدُّنْيَا, when he leaves the dunya, وَإِقْبَالٍ مِنَ الْآخِرَةِ, and he's turning towards the hereafter, when he's on his deathbed, نَزَلَ إِلَيْهِ مَلَائِكَةٌ مِنَ السَّمَاءِ, angels from the sama come, سُودُ الْوُجُوهُ, darkened faced, مَعَهُمْ سُمُوحٌ, these angels are darkened faced, their face is dark, صح? With them is سُمُوح. What is that? I'm a musuh. What does that mean? It means جَمْعُ الْمِسْحِ وَهُوَ اللِّبَاسُ الْخَشِنِ. They're wearing clothes which are khashin, يعني tough. What will they say? They will say to him, first of all, they sit next to his head. فَيَجْلِسُونَ مِنْهُ مَدَّ الْبَصَرِ ثُمَّ يَجِئُ مَلَكُ الْمَوْتِ. That's where they sit there. Their appearance is not appealing. Then the angel of death will come. And the angel of death will go to where? يَجْلِسُ عِنْدَ رَأْسِهِ. He will sit next to his head. فَيَقُولُ. He will then say, أَيَّتُهَا النَّفْسُ الْخَبِيثَةِ. The angel of death will say what? Filthy soul, come out. Oh, filthy soul, come out. For what? أُخْرُجِ إِلَى سَخَطٍ مِّنَ اللَّهِ وَغَضَبٍ. Come out to the anger and the wrath of your Lord. Then when the soul, when that is said to the soul, what does it do? فَتَفَرَّقُ فِي جَسَدِهِ. فَتَفَرَّقُ فِي جَسَدِهِ. It disperses into what? Into his body. The soul doesn't want to come out. It runs into his body. The other one was what? The angel will say to him what? The believer, the mu'min was what? أَيَّتُهَا النَّفْسُ الطَّيِّبَةِ. Oh, you noble soul. أُخْرُجِي إِلَى مَغْفِرَةٍ مِّنَ اللَّهِ وَرِضْوَانٍ. That was what was said to the believer, right? This disbeliever is the opposite. أَيَّتُهَا النَّفْسُ الْخَبِيثَةِ. أُخْرُجِي إِلَى سَخَطٍ مِّنَ اللَّهِ وَغَضَبٍ. And then the other one, what happened? His soul will come running out. This one, no. The soul will go back and he doesn't want to come out. So what would happen? So the angel will be forced to bring it out with force. فَيَنْتَزِعُهَا كَمَا يُنْتَزَعُ الصُّفُودُ مِنَ الصُّفُوفِ الْمَبْلُولِ. أَمَا مِنَ الصُّفُوفِ الْمَبْلُولِ. The way that a metal rod is run through cotton, that's how he's going to scrape it out of that person's body. He drags it. فَيَأْخُذُهَا فَإِذَا أَخَذَهَا لَمْ يَدَعَهَا فِي يَدِهِ طَرْفَةَ عَيْنٍ. And when the body, the way that person feels the agony of death when he's been taken out of his body, then once he's taken out, the angel will not hold it for a split second. He will throw it into that cloth. Okay, that tough cloth that the angel's carrying, that I mentioned, al-musuhi, that, يعني, which is the jam'u al-mish, which is libas al-khashin, not like the one before, whose cloth was soft, smelled nice. No, this was not that. He's a disbeliever. وَيَخْرُجُ مِنْهَا كَأَنْتَنِ رِيحِ جِيفَةٍ وُجِدَتْ عَلَى وَجْهِ الْأَرْضِ. The smell that comes from it is worse than any filthy smell that you've ever smelled in your life. Any corpse that you've ever smelled, this is the worst one. It's the worst. Ha, brothers and sisters. فَيَسْعَدُونَ بِهَا فَلَا يَمُرُّونَ بِهَا عَلَى مَلَئٍ مِّنَ الْمَلَائِكَةِ. And so this person, he will not go through any of the angels except that they say, مَا هَذَا الرُّوحُ الْخَبِيثُ. What is this evil soul? فَيَقُولُونَ, they say, فُلَانِ ibn فُلَانِ. That's who he is. And they will refer to him with what? Good name? نَا بِأَقْبَحِ أَسْمَائِهِ الَّتِي كَانَ يُسَمَّى بِهَا فِي الدُّنْيَا. They will refer to him as a bad name. حَتَّى يُنْتَهَى بِهَا إِلَى السَّمَاءِ الدُّنْيَا. Until he comes to the سَمَاءِ الدُّنْيَا. فَيُسْتَفْتَحُ لَهُ It will be requested for the door of Sama to be open. فَلَا يُفْتَحُ لَهُ The door will not be open for him. And this is where the Prophet recited the ayah that we were doing the tafsir of. And that's why I mentioned the whole story. The Prophet recited the ayah, لَا تُفَتَّحُ لَهُمْ أَبْوَابُ السَّمَاءِ وَلَا يَدْخُلُونَ الْجَنَّةَ حَتَّى يَلِجَ الْجَمَلُ فِي سَمِّ الْخِيَابِ Then the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam mentioned, Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala will say, اُكْتُوُ كِتَابَهُ فِي السِّجِّينِ Write his name in the Sijjin. And the Sijjin is the criminals and the evil people, their names is written in there. فِي الْأَرْضِ السُّفْلِي فَتُطْرَحُ رُوحُهُ his. His soul will be thrown to his body. And then the Prophet recited the ayah, وَمَنْ يُشْرِكْ بِاللَّهِ فَكَأَنَّمَا خَرَّ مِنَ السَّمَاءِ فَتَخْطَفُهُ الطَّيْرُ أَوْ تَهْوِي بِهِ الرِّيحُ فِي مَكَانِ صَحِيقًا That's the dealings of the criminals. يا إخوتي الكرام. So brothers and sisters, that's the point I wanted from the story. Then when the body is taken back, he's now in the grave. فَتُعَادُ رُوحُهُ فِي جَسَدِهِ وَيَأْتِيهِ مَلَكَانِ Two angels will come to him in the grave. فَيُجْلِسَانِهِ They will sit next to him and they will say, مَنْ رَبُّكْ Who's your Lord? And then he will say, لَا أَدْرِي I don't know. فَيَقُولَانِ لَهُ They will say, مَا دِينُ What's your religion? فَيَقُولُ لَا أَدْرِي That's what he say. فَيَقُولَانِ لَهُ They say to him, مَا هَذَا الرَّجُلُ الَّذِي بُعِثَ فِيكُمْ Who is this man that was sent from amongst you? فَيَقُولُ لَا أَدْرِي I don't know. فَيُنَادِي مُنَادٍ مِنَ السَّمَاءِ caller will call from the sky. And كذب فأفرشوا له من النار. Now this one, criminal, disbelieved, turned away. His grave is going to be turned into a pit of the pits of the hellfire. The door of the hellfire will be opened for him. And from there the heat and the evil smell of it, فيأتيه من حرها وسمومها will come to him. The smell, the heat. وَيُضَيَّقُ عَلَيْهِ قَبْرُهُ His grave will be tightened on him حَتَّى تَخْتَلِفَ فِيهِ أَضْلَاعُهُ Until his ribs, they cross by through each other وَيَأْتِيهِ رَجُلٌ قَبِيحُ الْوَجْهِ A man who looks despicable will come to him قَبِيحَ الثِّيَابِ His clothes are despicable مُنْتِنُ الرِّيحِ The smell that is coming from it is not pleasant فَيَقُولُ He will say to him أَبْشِرْ بِالَّذِي يَسُرُّكَ Glad tiding for something that's going to cause you distress and harm. هَذَا يَوْمُكَ الَّذِي كُنْتَ تُوعَدْ This is the day that you used to be promised. فَيَقُولُ He will then say, مَنْ أَنْتَ Who are you? فَوَجْهُكَ الْوَجْهُ الْيَجِيءُ بِالشَّرِّ فَوَجْهُكَ Your face is a what? الْوَجْهُ يَجِيءُ بِالشَّرِّ A face that's going to come with evil. Who are you? فَيَقُولُ He will then say, أَنَا عَمَلُكَ الْخَبِيثُ I am your filthy deeds. And the actions that you put forward, that's who I am. فَيَقُولُ He will then say, رَبِّ لَا تُقِيمِ السَّاعَةِ Oh Allah, don't allow the hour to come. Then Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, He says, وَلَا يَدْخُلُونَ الْجَنَّةَ حَتَّى يَلِجَ الْجَمَلُ فِي سَمِّ الْخِيَاطِ أي وَلَا يَدْخُلُ هَؤُلَاءِ الَّذِينَ كَذَّبُوا بِآيَاتِنَا The ones who have disbelieved in the verses of Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, who disbelieved in the message, who disbelieved in the messengers, who disbelieved in the day of judgment, who didn't take their religion serious, who لا يدخلون الجنة They won't enter Jannah. Okay, واستكبروا لا يدخلون الجنة And they were arrogant. Those people are not going to enter Jannah. حتى until what? حتى يلج الجمل في سم الخياط. What does that mean? Until a camel enters يدخل في ثقب الإبري إبرة. Until a camel goes through a needle. Small needle. Or it goes through a kettle where the water comes out, the camel goes inside that. Can it happen? No. As Allah tabarak wa ta'ala mentioned in another ayah that those people are not going to enter Jannah. Allah says, إِنَّهُ مَنْ يُشْرِكْ بِاللَّهِ فَقَدْ حَرَّمَ اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ الْجَنَّةِ وَمَأْوَاهُ النَّارِ وَمَا لِلظَّالِمِينَ مِنْ أَنصَارِ Allah made it haram for a disbeliever to enter Jannah. Also Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, He mentions, Subhanahu wa ta'ala, ونادى أصحاب النار أصحاب الجنة أن أفيضوا علينا من الماء أن أفيضوا علينا من الماء أو مما رزقكم الله قالوا إن الله حرمهما على الكافرين. هو ذا كافرين يا الذين اتخذوا دينهم لهوا ولعبا وغرتهم الحياة الدنيا فاليوم ننساهم كما نسوا لقاء يومهم هذا وما كانوا بآياتنا يجحدون. الله تبارك وتعالى, he told us, the people of the hellfire, ونادى أصحاب النار, the people of the hellfire will call out. أصحاب الجنة, the people of Jannah, أن أفيضوا علينا من الماء, pour over us water from the Jannah. أو مما رزقكم الله, or the food Allah has given you, give us something, water and food, give us something, please. قالوا, أهل الجنة will respond. And this is what they're going to say, إن الله, verily Allah, حرمهما, He has prohibited those two, water and food, He has prohibited it from what? That's taken from Jannah. على الكافرين, the disbelievers. Let alone you guys entering Jannah, the food that's taken from Jannah, the water that's taken from Jannah, it's haram for a disbeliever. No. Which disbelievers? الذين اتخذوا, the ones who have taken دينهم, their religion, لهوا ولعبا. They took their religion as a joke. Laugh. They Islam. What is this religion? Joking about the deen of Islam. Mocking the Prophet ﷺ. Mocking the message of Islam. That's what they did. وَغَرَّتْهُمُ الْحَيَاةُ الدُّنْيَا, and the dunya deceived them. Our country, our this. فَالْيَوْمَ نَنْسَاهُمْ, today they will be abandoned. كَمَا نَسُوا لِقَاءَ يَوْمِهِمْ هَذَا, the way that they abandoned and they left the remembrance of the day of judgment. They chose not to remember it. They will be abandoned like that in the hellfire. Allah then says, وَمَا كَانُوا بِآيَاتِنَا يَجْحَدُونَ. And they will be abandoned because of their hard-headedness when it came to Allah's verses, subhanahu wa ta'ala. And finally, Allah says, وَكَذَلِكَ, and like that. وَكَذَلِكَ here means, وَمِثْلَ هَذَا الْعِقَابِ نَجْزِ الْمُجْرِمِينَ. Like that is the way that we deal with the criminals. نُعَاقِبُ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا. Allah is saying, like that we punish and we deal with those who disbelieve. Who disbelieve in what? بِآيَاتِنَا, our verses. وَاسْتَكْبَرُوا عَنِ الْإِيمَانِ بِهَا, and are arrogant in believing Allah تبارك وتعالى. Allah says, now Allah is going to tell us what's for these people. لَهُم مِّن جَهَنَّمَ مِهَاد. For them, from جَهَنَّمَ is what? مِهَاد. فِرَاش مِنَ النَّار. There's going to be a where they're going to lie down in hellfire. They're going to be tossed all over. That's what Allah says, وَمِن فَوْقِهِمْ غَوَاش. So from the bottom is hellfire, and on the top is hellfire. فِرَاشٌ مِنَ النَّارِ مِنْ تَحْتِهِمْ وَمِنْ فَوْقِهِمْ غِطَاءٌ مِنَ النَّارِ. That's what's going to be for them. And then what about it? وَتُحِيطُ بِهِمُ النَّارَ مِنْ كُلِّ جَوَانِبِهِمْ, from all directions, the hellfire will be around them. Allah then says, وَكَذَلِكَ نَجْزِي, وَكَذَلِكَ, and like that, نَجْزِي الظَّالِمِينَ, we deal with the people who are zalimin. Allah mentions this in Surah Zumar. He says, لَهُمْ مِنْ فَوْقِهِمْ ظُلَلٌ مِنَ النَّارِ وَمِنْ تَحْتِهِمْ ظُلَلٌ ذَلِكَ يُخَوِّفُ اللَّهُ بِهِ عِبَادَهُ يَا عِبَادِ فَاتَّقُونَ. Allah says, لَهُمْ مِنْ فَوْقِهِمْ, above them is what? ظُلَلٌ مِنَ النَّارِ, a shade of from the hellfire, burning them from the top. وَمِنْ تَحْتِهِمْ, from beneath they're also being burnt. Why? Because they disbelieved in Allah. They disbelieved in the messengers. They disbelieved in the message. They mocked the believers. They mocked the religion. وَكَذَلِكَ, and like that, نَجْزِي الظَّالِمِينَ. Allah destroys them, subhanahu wa ta'ala. They've earned the wrath of Allah, tabarak wa ta'ala. May Allah, tabarak wa ta'ala, protect us from such a thing. سُبْحَانَكَ اللَّهُمَّ بِحَمْدِي أَشْهَدُ أَنْ لَا إِلَهِ إِلَّا اللَّهِ أَسْتَغْفِرُكَ وَأَتُوبُ إِلَيْهِ.
Ramadan with AMAU. Make this the best Ramadan you've ever had by joining our exclusive online community with regular private classes, digital resources, weekly accountability sessions, and daily Qur'an gatherings. This is one opportunity you definitely do not want to miss. So sign up now at amau.org/Ramadan, and we look forward to welcoming you on the other side.